Hey guys, Ron White here, two-time USA memory champion. You know, I've been teaching memory seminars for 30 years, over three decades. It'll be 32 years this summer. And this new thing has come out, ChatGPT, OpenAI, artificial intelligence. And I'm like, what is this? What is this? So I start Googling around in this. I don't even know if Googling around is the right term, but I'm in the chat room and I start asking it questions. And then I'm like, I want to ask it questions about memory training. I want to see what this artificial intelligence knows about how to learn faster. So on this episode, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to type some questions into ChatGPT on how to remember what you read, how to learn faster, that kind of stuff. And we're going to see the response it gives us. And then I'm going to just talk about whatever it says. Whatever it says, I'm going to give you my thoughts. It may be the exact same things I teach. It may be something different I teach. It may be a different perspective. I don't know. But I think this will be a good way to get some different perspectives. If you've been following me for a while, you've gotten my perspectives on how to learn faster. So let's see about what this ChatGPT thing says. This OpenAI, is that what it's called? Artificial intelligence. And let's see if it's smarter than me. Well, it is smarter than me, but let's see if it has a different perspective than me. That's a good thing on how to learn faster. So let's type this in. Let's type in how to remember what you read. Boom. Okay. All right. Look at this. All right. It says here are some strategies that may help you to remember. By the way, I typed in how to remember what you read in the voice. I said, hey, teach me how to remember what I read in the voice of Tupac. I don't know if it's going to do it in the voice of Tupac or not, but let's see. How to remember what you read. Number one, it says summarize the main points. Try to succinctly summarize the main ideas or arguments in the text. This can help you understand the overall structure and key takeaways from the reading. I think that's good. If you want to remember what you read, summarize. That reminds me of a book by Isaac Watts. Isaac Watts wrote a book in the 1700s called Improvement of the Mind. And he talked about if you want to remember what you read, he said, you know, everybody says, I'm going to read 50 books this year or whatever. I don't know what they were reading in the 1700s. But in the 1700s, Isaac Watts was making this point. He was like, most people will just zoom through books and not remember them. To remember what you read, summarize the main points. Put them in your own words. So I think that is, if not only does summarizing the points after you reading them and talking about them and putting them in your own words help you remember it, it helps you make sure that you're understanding it. So I think that's a great takeaway. Number one, summarize the main points. After you read something, summarize it. Talk about it. Number two, take notes. While you read, take notes on important points, quotes, or ideas that stand out. This will give you a reference to look back on as you review the material. On this note-taking point here, there's actually been some studies done. Now, this was done for a classroom setting, not necessarily reading the book, but I think it applies here. And here is what the studies were. They put somebody in a classroom, and they had them take notes while the teacher was talking. They had somebody not take notes while the teacher was talking, and then they had another person type notes on the computer. Do you know who remembered more of what the teacher said? Was it the person who wrote no notes? Was it the person who did handwritten notes? Or was it the person who typed the notes? It was the person who handwrote notes. Now, and they did several studies on this. It wasn't just one person. It was a group study. And in general, the person who hand wrote the notes remembered more. So then we got to analyze the data and like, why could this be? Well, the person who's not taking notes didn't have anything to go back and review later. So that probably hurt their memory. They might not have been engaged that much because they weren't taking notes or doing something. So we can kind of discount why they didn't remember as much. Now, why did the person who hand wrote the notes remember more than the person who typed the notes? There could be a lot of right reasons on this, but the theory is that when you handwrite notes, you're having to summarize what you're learning. You can't type it out. You can't write it out word for word. Your brain is having to assimilate and summarize the data as the teacher's talking. But when you're typing, sometimes you can type so fast, you're almost starting to type word for word with the teacher's talking. But when you're typing word for word, you're not having to analyze it and summarize it. And that actual process of doing that cements it in your memory more. So I bring that up because it says take notes. Well, how are you going to take notes? Are you going to get on a computer and just word for word type everything you're reading? Or are you going to do it by hand? by hand, there is some evidence to suggest that you'll remember more. Just an idea, do whatever you want, especially in this day and age where there's computers and technology everywhere. It's kind of difficult to say don't take notes by on your computer, because I certainly do. Number three, so one was summarize the main points, two was take notes, three is practice active reading. What does it mean by active reading? It says try to engage with the text as you read. Okay, rather than passively consuming it. This might include underlining key points, asking questions about the material, or checking your understanding as you go. Okay, all right, okay. So practice active reading. Try to engage with the text. You know what? This is something that I believe you should do. If you get to something when you're reading, and you don't understand it, there is a word that you don't understand, underline it. That way you can go back later and look it up, and that's active reading. You're engaged in the reading process. Oh, I don't understand this word, or I don't understand this reference, or what does this mean? And then you go and you investigate that. About 2 years ago, I was reading a lot of books on memory that were written in the 1700s and 1800s, and they would often quote other authors in those books. So I would go and buy that other author's book, and it just led me down this rabbit hole of such, a great understanding. If you don't understand something when you're reading it, look it up. That engages your brain in the process. Number four, so summarize the main points, take notes, practice active reading. Number four, test yourself. Okay, this is good. I'm gonna see what this says, but I have some feedback on this one. Test yourself. Here's what it says. Try recalling the key points or arguments from the text without looking back at your notes or the text itself. Guys, that's huge. That's huge. Let me read again what he or she, or is it, what pronoun is it when you're talking about OpenAI, ChatGPT? I don't know. Try recalling the key points or arguments from the text without looking back at your notes or the text. Guys, this is huge. This is huge. And here's what it's saying. When you are looking at your notes, don't just read your notes again. That is a passive review. It's a passive review. You want to do active reviews. You want to have your notes right here, and you want to look away and try to remember what the information is. Why? Number one, you're engaging your brain and your brain, making your brain think. But number two, it's impossible to trick yourself. You can't be looking away and trick yourself into knowing that you know the information. However, if you're just reading it over and over again, you recognize it, and so you're kind of tricking yourself. Oh, yeah, I know that. Well, no, you really didn't know that. Maybe you're just recognizing it again. There is a difference between recognizing and really knowing something, and that's why this point of testing yourself by looking away is huge. That's huge. Bravo, ChatGPT, help artificial intelligence. Not just because the memory guy agrees with you, but I do. I agree with you. I've agreed with everything you've said here. So, all right, good job. But I think I've added a little bit of background on why I agree, and that's what's hopefully valuable. By the way, if you're watching this video, I have a memory course. It's called Black Belt Memory, and I teach people how to improve their memory. I got a link down below in the description. Go down there, get a free gift for my Black Belt Memory course. It's really an awesome course on improving your memory. But let's go back here to the next point. It says discuss or teach the material. You know what? I'm going to go back to point number four before I jump to discuss or teach the material. Point number four was test yourself. Here is a little technique that you should do every time you pick up a book. Tell yourself, when you pick up the book, after I read this chapter, there's going to be a test. Point number four is test yourself. Do this. You know what? After I read this chapter, Ron, there's going to be a test. Well, is there really a test? Is there really going to be an exam? No, maybe not. But if there is or isn't, tell yourself that. Why? Because when you think there's going to be a test for something, it focuses your brain. You were zoomed in on the focus. Tell yourself that there's going to be a test, and that will focus you. Then you know what? Make there be a test afterwards. Give yourself the test. Because if you tell yourself there's going to be a test, but then afterwards you don't give yourself a test, that's going to start losing its effectiveness. Because you know, nah, there's really not going to be a test. I don't have. So give yourself a test. so you this thing that you tell yourself doesn't lose effectiveness. How do you give yourself a test? Well, this is what I do. I do jujitsu, right? So when I go into jujitsu class, I tell myself, after this lesson, after this class today, there's going to be a test. And there is a test. The test is on my drive home. On the drive home, I review and I talk about what I learned. And then whenever I get home, I have a jujitsu journal and I write out what I learned in that class today. There's two tests. There's an oral test on my drive home and a written test when I get home. I'm giving myself the test. I tell myself there's a test. I go to class. On the way home from class, I verbalize what I learned. When I get home, I write down what I learned. There is a test. And that, boom, focuses my brain to remember more when I'm learning. Point number five. So there's 5 points to how to remember what you read according to artificial intelligence, ChatGPT. Number five, discuss or teach the material. That's great. That's another great point. That's another great point. Discuss or teach the material. Richard Feynman was a theoretical physicist. He lived in the, or he made his prominence really in the 1980s, maybe a little bit before that too, but I think that's when I started hearing about him, was the 1980s. Richard Feynman, a theoretical physicist, he developed something known as the Feynman technique. Wow, what a novel name for that technique. But part of that was, whenever you learn something, teach it to others. And Richard Feynman would say, you know what, when you get done with a class, teach it to something. Even if you're teaching it to the microphone, you're like, hey, microphone, look what I just learned. I want to teach you something today about what I just learned. I just learned this about Abraham Lincoln, or I just learned this. You're teaching it to somebody. Even if it's your dog or a coffee mug or a screen or a wall or an ant or a bird or whatever, teach it to somebody. And I kind of got off here, but let's see what this was. Discuss or teach the material. Yes, this is what Richard Feynman taught. One of the best ways to solidify your understanding of a text is to explain it to someone. Agreed. Try teaching or discussing with someone the content of the text. This will help you identify gaps in your understanding and reinforce what you know. Awesome. Awesome point. So maybe you want to have a study group. You know, maybe there is, if you're studying for a history test or you're studying for a certification, you know, there's a lot of people out there studying for the project manager certification, which is a business certification, or you're studying for the bar exam, or you're studying for a nursing exam. Join a study group. And in that study group, talk with other people about what you're learning. Talking about it will fill in the gaps. They understood this and you didn't, but you understood this and they didn't. So you're able to talk about it, help each other that way, but also see what you're missing. But also, when you talk about something or explain it, it reinforces in your mind and you start to begin, do I really understand this or do I not? Do I have just a surface level understanding or do I have a deep understanding of something? So today I asked ChatGPT, artificial intelligence, how to remember what you read. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. Not once in here did they reference memory techniques or mnemonics. You know, if you've been following me, you know I'm a huge fan of the Mind Palace and mnemonics and memory techniques. So I am going to say I do use those. I use them. And if you want to know what the Mind Palace is, I'll put a link down below in the description of how to use the Mind Palace to memorize. ChatGPT didn't suggest that today, so we'll say, okay, cool, we're just responding to what they said. So in summary, how do you remember what you read? Number one, summarize that they have 5 points. He said, or she said, I don't know, it said, it. It's probably an it. Summarize the main points. Great idea, because if you can summarize it, Albert Einstein said, if you can't explain something to a six-year-old, you don't understand it yourself. Summarizing it, being able to summarize something, makes your brain engage it and prove that you know it. Number two, take notes. I think you can take notes on a laptop. I think you can take notes on a Kindle, or not a Kindle, an iPad, or by hand. I do have a lot by hand, and I have a lot on my iPad and notepad too. But beware of the pitfalls. If you're typing it into your computer, remember, just summarize the main points. Don't type it out word for word. Practice active reading, absolutely. If you don't know what you're reading, look it up. Test yourself, tests are big. It engages your brain, and discuss or teach the material. Guys, my name is Ron White. I wanted to see what the artificial intelligence says about how to remember what you read. If you want to improve your memory, I have a wonderful memory course on improving your memory. It's called Black Belt Memory. Click the link down below in the description. Get my memory course on how to improve your memory. I have a free gift there waiting for you. By the way, guys, look. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Please comment. Tell me down below, how do you remember what you read? Tell me, what are you asking ChatGPT artificial intelligence questions? Comment down below with the things that you're asking this artificial intelligence. Comment down below, how do you remember what you read? And I'll see you on the next video. If you subscribe, you have to subscribe.